Okay, guys, welcome to the Brain Athlete Show. I want to talk to you today about caffeine. Is caffeine good for your memory? Is it the secret trick to focus your memory? Do I use caffeine when I'm trying to memorize? So that's what we're gonna talk about in this video. By the way, I'm a two-time USA memory champion. I used to hold the record for the fastest to memorize a deck of cards in the United States. If you wanna get my memory course, I have a free gift for you. Click the link down below in the description, blackbeltmemory.com, and you can get a free gift on how to improve your memory, plus you can get my black belt memory course. So watch this video, but also before you go anywhere, don't forget to click the link down below. Now, here's the answer. Is caffeine good for your memory or is it bad for your memory? Does it focus your memory or does it hurt your memory? Should you use it? Should you not use it? When should you use it? This is something that I'm going to be honest with you that I have been so conflicted about. I have. I'm not going to lie to you because I try to live a healthy life. I do. I'm not perfect at it. I could lose a few pounds here and there. 5-10 pounds would definitely be healthy. You know, I don't always eat the best, but I try. I try to drink 100 ounces of water a day. I took my vitamins this morning. I took my shake this morning. But you know what I also did? I took my 5-hour energy this morning, 100 milligrams of caffeine to give me that extra jolt. And as I do, I wonder, am I doing something bad for my memory or good for my memory? Well, for those of you who believe caffeine helps your memory, I have some good news for you. There is evidence to support this, okay? John Hopkins University has done a research, and I'll link to the research down in the description of this video, has conducted research showing that caffeine does indeed help your memory. It does improve your memory. It improves your ability to focus because what it does is it stimulates the body's central nervous system and to produce dopamine. It boosts the production of dopamine, which is a neurotransmitter in your body, which is responsible for focus and your ability to maintain attention. Now, too much caffeine is not a good thing. Now, here's the thing. When I competed in the USA Memory Championship, and I set the record for the fastest to memorize a deck of cards. I set the number for the longest number deck of cards in the United States. That's an important distinction. I set the record for the longest number memorized in the United States at the time, 167 consecutive digits. When I was walking into that most important memory thing of memory exercise, memory challenge of my life, did I take some caffeine that morning? I did not. Why? Because I wanted to be calm. I wanted to be relaxed. I wanted to be at peace, almost a zen-like mode. I wanted to be able to pick up that deck of cards and zoom through it peacefully, at calm, not nervous, not jittery, but peace. So I did not use caffeine. I had water there. I was naturally, I think caffeine would have hurt me in that scenario in the USA Memory Championship. You need calm, you need peace to be able to memorize fast like that. But today, I took caffeine. What's the difference? The difference is I had a lot to do today and I needed that jolt, boom, 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 to get my wheels going. And there is scientific studies that this is effective. John Hopkins University, when they did their research on caffeine, they measured it with 100 milligrams of caffeine, 200 milligrams of caffeine, and 300 milligrams of caffeine. They found that the person who took 100 milligrams of caffeine showed almost no improvement in their memory. The person who took 200 milligrams of caffeine did show improvements in their memory. And the person who took 300 milligrams of caffeine showed almost no improvement over the person who took 200 milligrams of caffeine. So they determined that 200 milligrams of caffeine was the optimal level of caffeine for memory and focus improvement, with 100 showing almost no improvement, 300 showing no benefit over 200. The FDA, now what is an unsafe amount of caffeine? The FDA has determined that 400 milligrams should be safe for the average adult for caffeine. Now I'm gonna be honest with you, that's a lot of caffeine. That is a lot of caffeine. That is 4 5-hour energies, okay? I don't feel comfortable with that. I think you're going to get caffeine from teas, and you can get it from a lot of different sources. So, but 400 is the limit. I would not even approach that if I was you. I would try to stay at 200 if you're going to do it. And you want to pick and choose when you do it. This study by Johns Hopkins University said that if they gave them the caffeine an hour before the test, and then they tested them an hour later, they almost saw no improvement. So it was almost closer or during the test, like immediately, because the effects of caffeine do begin to diminish. That's why it's called 5-hour energy, right? It sounds like I'm endorsing them right now. I'm not. You know, it wears off. It wears off over time. And also caffeine, really, it's not giving you energy that you don't have. It's just borrowing energy from the future. That's why you crash, all right, afterwards. So I'm going to tell you that there are studies that show caffeine can be good for you and it can improve your memory. Coffee caffeine may be a better source of caffeine than energy drinks that have tons and tons of sugar if you're not putting tons and tons of sugar in your coffee. So just be careful when you're taking these energy drinks, how much sugar do they have in them? Because if they have a lot of sugar as well as caffeine, that could be bad. I'm sure the energy drinks that I take have sugar in them. So this is probably my most unhealthy habit. But today I only did one. Would I take caffeine before I gave a speech? I have, and it's not optimal because I'm too jittery when I'm up on stage. I'm not able to memorize naturally. I want to be calm. Do I take caffeine before I go to a memory tournament? I do not, because I want to be calm. Studies have also shown that if you are taking caffeine when you study and you don't take caffeine during the test, the memories are not going to be as strong. But here's the crazy thing. This is crazy. You take caffeine when you study and you don't take caffeine during the test, you might not remember this as clearly because somehow your brain is linking the taste and the sensation of caffeine to the memories. But if you take a 5-hour energy when you're studying and a 5-hour energy during the test or Monster or whatever, or coffee, you're going to link it and you might even remember more. So if you don't take caffeine when you study, don't take caffeine during the test. If you take caffeine when you study, maybe consider a little bit before the test. That's a scientific study, and I'll link it down below. Overall, though, I want to be careful. I am always careful on this podcast, on this channel, about recommending things that aren't natural. I really believe in natural everything as you can get. And caffeine and these energy drinks, you're supplementing it with something that's not necessarily a natural. Now, here are some negatives of caffeine. Caffeine has been shown to improve memory, but it's also been shown to make your memory worse. It makes your memory worse because there has been shown that if you are shown something and then you're kind of prompted, like a flashcard later, you're given half of the information, caffeine can help you remember the data, you know, if you're prompted with something. But if you're not prompted with something, caffeine can actually hurt. You can't even think of anything. So be careful what you're trying to study. If it is a task where you're having to just do free recall, for example, if you're going in to write an essay, the test is an essay test, caffeine may not help you because you're not really given prompted by anything. But if you're being prompted by questions kind of give you a prompt. Then caffeine has been known to maybe help you a little bit. It's kind of, there are studies that back this up, and I'm just telling you what I've read in the studies. I'll link to the studies down below, but there's positive and negatives to caffeine. People have also been known to have false memories that aren't true under caffeine. Overall, the negatives I see for caffeine are it can make you jittery. It can increase your heart palpitations. It dehydrates you. If you are doing caffeine, make sure you're drinking plenty of water as well, because you are going to be more dehydrated. Pay very close attention to your intake of water when you're taking in caffeine, because you will be more dehydrated. And a dehydrated brain can't focus. So if you're taking caffeine to focus your brain and then you're dehydrating yourself, well, you're canceling them out. Drink the caffeine, but then drink a glass of water to hydrate yourself, to get the full benefit of the caffeine. Caffeine is a vasoconstrictor. It constricts your blood vessels, which decreases the blood supply to your brain, which is why if you have too much caffeine, you can get a headache. So it is important, again, to drink plenty of water to help that blood flow. Seizures, high blood pressure, sleep disruption are all side effects of caffeine. Overall, in conclusion, in the short term, can caffeine give you a boost of focus? Yes, it can, if you don't do too much. If you do too much, you can get headaches, you can get jittery, and you can have trouble sleeping. Do I do caffeine? Certainly, sometimes I do. I will do caffeine if I need a jolt of energy, if I'm trying to study some information, and I think it's gonna help me study that information. But if I am competing in something like the USA Memory Championship where I just wanna be calm, I do not consume caffeine. So use your own judgment, find your own body, find your right number. 200 milligrams of caffeine may be a safe number for you, definitely not more than 400 milligrams of caffeine. Find your own body, find how your body responds to caffeine, but be careful. It could lead to heart problems. It could lead to sleep problems. It could lead to high blood pressure. Be careful. If you really want to improve your memory and you don't want to do it with caffeine, get my Black Belt Memory Course. Click the link down below. Get my Black Belt Memory Course. I have a free gift there for you. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Comment below and tell me what your source of caffeine is. Where do you get your caffeine? Do you get it from soft drinks? Do you get it from energy drinks? How do you get your caffeine? Do you consume caffeine? What are your thoughts on caffeine? Let me know if you think caffeine helps your memory, if caffeine improves your memory, if caffeine boosts your focus, and I'll see you on the next lesson.